This video will be about using the solver function on the TI84 calculator to find an unknown variable. We will begin by solving a simple example. Start by pressing on. The display on your calculator should light up. Press Math, then scroll down until you see Solver. Press Enter. Make sure the equation is set equal to 0, then type it into the calculator. Press Enter. The equation will be displayed at the top. The next line will read x equals 0. This is a guess you can enter to help the calculator figure out the answer. For this example, we will use x equals 0 as our guess. The following line reads bound equals followed by some numbers. This gives the calculator a range to guess between. We will keep the range the same as well, as it is already set for a very large interval. Press alpha, then enter. In order to get an answer from Solver, the cursor must be next to the guess value, and you must press alpha, enter, or solve in green. The calculator returns its best guess for what value will make the equation equal to 0. Plug the guess back into the original equation. This will show that the answer makes the equation effectively equal to 0, so it is correct. Now we'll do a few more examples that are a little more complex. Start by returning to the solver screen. If there's an equation already plugged into solver from previous use, you can erase it by pressing clear. Solve cosine x equals x for 0, then plug it into the solver. Guess 0 and press alpha, enter to start solver. Solver returns an answer of 0.9998. Try a few different guesses to see if the answer is affected by the guess. The answer is always 0.9998. We can verify this by looking at a graphical representation of the equation. The only value that will make this equation equal to 0 is 0.9998. Plugging this value back into the equation will show that it is the correct solution. The next example will be a rearranged version of the previous equation. Now it will be x equals arc cosine x. Make sure the equation is solved for 0. Return to the solver screen and plug it into the solver. Guess 0. Because the equation was only rearranged and not altered, the returned solution should match the one from the previous example. Press alpha, enter to start solver. Solver returns an answer of 0.9998, so it is consistent with the previous example. Try a few more guesses. First, guess 0.5. Solver returns another consistent answer. Now guess 1. Solver returns an error message. Because the only thing we changed was our guess, there must be a problem with our guess. Scroll down to Go To and press Enter to return to the solver screen. Guess 2. Again, Solver returns an error message. These error messages suggest that there is some limitation on the domain of our equation. This can be explained by examining the graphical representation of the equation. The graph reveals that the function x minus arc cosine x has a domain limited to values between negative 1 and 1. This means that guessing negative 1, 1, or any value not within that range will return an error message. Notice too that the graph never crosses the x-axis, meaning there is no value that will make the equation equal to 0. Check the answer solver returned. Plugging this value back into the equation will return the closest value to zero that can be reached for the given function. The final example will be a more complicated equation. Solve this equation for zero, return to the solver screen, and plug the equation into the solver. Guess zero and press alpha, enter to start solver. Solver returns a value of 0.366. Now guess 1. This time, solver returns an entirely different value of 0.705. Examining the graph will reveal that the equation has three values that make it equal to zero. So there are three possible answers solver can reach, depending on the guess. A third guess of negative 5 will allow solver to find the third and final answer for this equation. Checking these answers algebraically shows solver returned the correct values. While solver can be a very powerful tool, it's important to recognize that certain equations have more than one solution. For this reason, using multiple guesses in solver, as well as a graphical representation of an equation, will help solver return the desired solution.